All scores in the distribution affect the mean. Think of the mean like a teeter-totter. Where should the pivot go so that it balances? These rocks or balls represent the salaries of the geography majors. Now, if this were a teeter-totter, where should the pivot go so that it balances? That's basically the mean, which in this data set of the salaries of geography majors is 47,718, like you calculated. Now, if we were to add another ball, say here, then the teeter-totter would tip. Therefore, the pivot would have to move this way so that it keeps balancing. So you can see that all scores affect the mean. You've also seen that the mean can be described with a formula. We described the sample mean as x bar, which is the sum of the values divided by the number of values, and the population mean, sum of the values divided by the number in the population. This is also true, that many samples from the same population will have similar means. For now, I'll just show you this applet again, where if we pick a sample of size 5, we get that the mean is roughly in the middle. And if we do it again, we get that the mean is roughly in the middle. Let's do it a few more times. Now we've calculated 10 simulated means from this distribution, and they're all roughly similar. This is actually a very important and awesome concept, and we're going to go into this in a lot more depth later in the course. Also, the mean of a sample can be used to make inferences about the population it came from. This relates to this last property of the mean, because you saw that all the samples are pretty similar, and that they roughly approximated the population mean. It's only the last one that's not a property of the mean. If we bring up the pivot example again, let's say we added a stone way out here. Is this going to change the mean? You betcha. It's going to have to go to the left somewhere so that this will still balance. Let's explore this point a little more.